standing, if you will, please. I'm sure that all of you in this room either had children or grandchildren who have played with the Transformers, a very popular item for children as well as movies and comics and so forth. But they were aliens that came from outer space somewhere to come to Earth, and they were robots, but they were transformed into automobiles and trucks and so forth. And kids love being able to take those and transform them from their robot into those particular things. Today I want to talk about transformational worship. What happens or what should happen to us when we come to worship God? Today's going to be a day of worship. Take a look at the screen. Worship is transformation. God is in the business of changing people. The Holy Spirit is in the business of transforming lives from old to new, dead to living, hurting and broken to healed and recreated. This is the call of evangelism. This is the call of the gospel. It is the call of worship. And in the process, God takes broken lives and transforms them into a worshiper of the Most High God. Let's sing together.
under heaven, given to men by which we must be saved. At the mention of your name, storms cease. At the mention of your name, mountains must move. At the mention of the name of Jesus, demons tremble and sickness flees.
We give all that praise and glory to God because He is excellent and of the strength. In the Greek, the word change means to change the figure or to be transformed. This is the word implied in 2 Corinthians 5:17, which says, if anyone belongs to Christ, there is a new creation. The old things have gone, everything is made new. Believe that this morning? Amen. That is the word of God. That's right. And His Spirit come to change our lives. To change the way that we see things. Reading a book right now that getting ready to start the second of the series of this. And it's by my favorite author called Ted Decker. In this series, he's talking about the life of Christ. He puts it into a novel form, but he uses scripture all throughout it. And it's just really beginning to open my eyes to some things. It's like, oh, I never thought about it that way before. And even though it's a novel, he's bringing truth. I have to see what Jesus wants me to see. To be the new person He wants me to be. Not just the same person who frets, worries, and stews over everything every week. Then on Sunday morning, we come and praise God, and we do the whole thing all over again. That He wants us to give it all up to Him. To say, I have been changed. I look at things differently because I see them through the eyes of Jesus. I'm changed. I pray you can say and sing the same thing this morning since Jesus came into my life. I'm changed. Now you sing, you stand if you like, or sit if you like, but just sing out. Let the Lord hear your praise this morning.
Oh,
words like renovate, convert, restore, switch, mend, retool, and even reestablish or refurbish, communicate this transformation principle. Our worship, our demonstration for our love for God, our adoration, our exaltation of God, that which we experience privately and corporately when we're with the Lord, should be so engaging, so personal, so defining, that when we leave God's presence, we are different. We are changed. We are transformed. Sometimes the change is immediately evident, like when a burden is lifted as we repent of our sins. At other times, the change is gradual and over a period of time. But there is no doubt, and catch this, the presence of God is hard to describe, but the absence of God is easy to detect. This morning, we'd like to teach you a song that may be new to some of you. And so, if you know what you sing along with us, we're going to sing it through with the choir ones that I want you to sing with us. It's entitled, Great is the Lord.
Thank you.
It's not the worship songs or the gospel songs that transforms lives. It's not the prayers we pray, the sermons we deliver, the engaging and moving videos about missions that we watch, the offerings we bring, the invitations we give, or the testimonies we share that transforms our lives. Only the Holy Spirit transforms our lives. Not our acts, not our service, not the taking of communion or formal or informal procedure in worship. Actually, our acts of worship do nothing to change us. But it is when we worship, when we give ourselves totally without reservation to the Lord, when we focus on the Lord alone and rid ourselves of the distractions of this ungodly, self-centered, self-consuming world, it is then, during those moments of self-examination and solitude, that the Holy Spirit begins to break down the bitterness, the anger, the self-promoting attitudes, and the spirit of greed in our hearts. And it is that kind of transformation that changes a life, a family, a church, and a nation. It happened to Jacob at the ford of the Jabbok. He wrestled with God all night. In the morning, he was transformed. Jonah experienced transformation in the belly of a fish. He repented of his selfishness. Ezekiel was transformed by his worship. The backward prophet was transformed as he saw the glory of the Lord. His ambitions were changed when he felt the hand of the Lord upon him. Isaiah was transformed in the process, saw the glory of God high and lifted up. His speech was transformed. And his response to the transformation experience, here am I. Saul was transformed as he worshiped Jesus. God changed his name to Paul. The great apostle was forever changed on a Damascus highway. Peter, likewise, was transformed in another room when tongues of fire hovered above the apostles' heads. They began telling the gospel message in other languages. 3,000 men were saved that day. Transformation. Let's participate in transformations when you worship the Lord in communion with Him. Father God, sometimes we come in the mornings just having rushed to get here and just grateful that we made it in time. And other times we come, Father, anticipating the move of your presence among us. Father, I pray that even now, as we begin to partake of the community, that we can just rid ourselves of all the things that are outside of this very moment. We can concentrate on you and concentrate on you alone for the sacrifice that you made for us. Thank you, Jesus, for your obedience to the Father. Thank you that today that you had set up before that time for us to be able to take a communion. Take this bread and take this cup and be reminded, Father, the stripes that fall on us because of our sin. Thank you for the broken body, Father, because our sin is so weighty. I ask, Father, for your blessed appearance before us. Move in our hearts. And move in our minds, Father. Move in our minds to remove everything from us except you and you alone. To worship the Spirit and the truth. In Christ. Thank you.
Thank you. to hear that lovely praise.
Have you heard? Can you hear that? Do you know my Jesus? Stephen, Richard, and Marilyn Hargett. I've known Richard for a number of years. His brother Ron Hargett is one of my very, very close friends. That's how I first met Richard. But Richard and his new wife Marilyn, they've been married how many months? 3 months. They've been attending here for several weeks, been here just about every Sunday, sitting right there. And he told me a number of weeks back, he said, honey, we just love it. We love it at Broadway. So he called me up this week and says, no, we want to place our membership. And I said, well, you might have heard this or this. He says, he told me a while ago, he says, we qualify. We're in. So they want the Broadway Christian Church to be their church family. If I recall this, Ron has told me, and I suppose you do, grew up in the church right across the street, Centenary Methodist, the white church that we used to own. That was used to be Centenary. That was the church that these boys grew up in. Their dad used to take them out front and beat them with a switch for acting up. Yeah. So. And if you continue to act up, we'll beat you still. All right. We are so thankful. So I'm going to ask you to make that confession that I know you made many years ago. In fact, he's kind of a lay preacher, chaplain on the side, but I know you believe this. But the congregation needs to hear this, say this as well. We believe that Jesus is the Christ, the Son of the living God. We want to serve the Broadway. Please welcome Richard and Mary.
It's been a wonderful morning. Would you stand with us as we pray? Father God, what a glorious day of worship. I praise you, Father, and thank you for accepting our praise this morning. I ask now, Father, that you would just take our hearts and our minds and change them. Transform them, Father. May we be in the Word of God. May your Holy Spirit move through us to teach us more and more so we can know you more. In Jesus' name. Amen. Have a great week. Don't forget the children's musical tonight at 5 in the theater, June 4th and 5th, Concert of Praise.